Welcome to the CS++ video series where we attempt to make computer science topics as accessible and available as possible to as many people as possible. This is an episode in the CS101 series. I do recommend that you watch all of the videos in the 101 series before moving on to the 201 series, but of course you can do what you would like. Now, this one is going to be pretty straightforward, I think, and it is the question of what are bits, nibbles, bytes, and words. Again, we try to keep things as high level and as approachable as possible. So at the most simple definition, a bit is either the value 0 or 1. It is either false or true. And we like to talk about computers basically just processing zeros and ones, which is both true and also almost too much of a simplification. Now, a nibble, or some people spell this with a Y, is 4 bits. So something like that would be a nibble. Now, I think, and I'm not 100% certain, but I think the definition of nibble kind of came after the definition for byte existed, but I could be wrong here. A byte is 8 bits. Now, if you think about it, that's why a nibble, it's kind of like a small byte, if you will. So that might be something like this, which is 8 bits. Now, bytes are used commonly in programming, and programming languages such as C are designed around the ability to actually be able to process data in chunks of bytes. Now, don't worry about that a whole lot right now, but it could be interesting to you to go and look up the history of the C programming language if you are already familiar with such things. The question is, what is a word? And the definition of word can actually vary a lot from device to device and from operating system to operating system. It's basically, by some definition, the native size of your computer. It's possible that your computer processes data 16 bits at a time, or 32 bits, or 64 bits. And you could find lots of discussion and disagreement about what exactly it means to have a word amount of data, but it is basically probably more than 1 byte and approximately equivalent to whatever your computer knows how to natively work with. And so for the sake of kind of bringing this around, this 64 bits is most computers today are 64-bit computers, and it would be fair to say that is the native word size of most computers is 64 bits, which is 4 bytes. But if we go back to the early days of the PC world, then we would see 16-bit computers. And then when we move to the 386 era, we got 32-bit words. But I digress here. Let's just say we're currently living in a 64-bit world, but you might see things that are older definitions where you have, say, word is 16 bits, and then D word or double word is 32 bits. This is all just to point out that the definition of word is a quite bit more nebulous, but we pretty much all collectively agree on these. Okay, so that answered the question of what are bits, nibbles, bytes, and words. And I always try to have a homework assignment for you here. Let's say Think of your favorite childhood computer. I don't know what that might have been. Or gaming device. Let's say maybe it was the Super Nintendo or Jaguar, perhaps. Or you remember some sort of old Packard Bell. Now, if you don't have a favorite old childhood computer, just look up the computer that you happen to have used first or might currently be using. And then go and research the word size of that computer and see what you find out. There's a little, maybe side little research project here for this homework assignment. You might learn a thing or two, particularly if you happen to come from an era when you remember the, bit wars, when everyone was talking about how this new gaming device is 32 bits, which makes it better than all the previous ones. This is a much larger topic as usual, but I think that's a good place to end this episode. So thanks for watching, and hope to see you in the next one.